Hey there, I'm Chris. I'm here to talk about the difference between rebasing and merging. I'm a developer on GitKraken. I'll be talking about the differences between the two and when to use one versus the other. So let's get started. So for starters, let's say we have a branch with commits on. We'll call this one master. And then we have say at some point we split off into a separate branch, we'll say a feature branch. We'll call this feature. So when we're talking about a merge, basically what we're going to do, we're trying to take all the commits on this branch and put them onto into the master branch. So what we're actually going to do is merge all these changes into one commit and put them on top of this master branch. So when we're doing that, this is what the graph would look like after that's done. We're actually just taking all the changes from this branch and moving it into the master branch. And some of the benefits of this is that we're not rewriting history. We're not changing any of these commits before we merge them in. So you get a lot more flexibility with your commits, and there's no danger of overwriting history that a lot of people are concerned with. So the difference with rebasing, just draw these branches again. Draw the feature branch. So basically, what we're doing with rebasing is we're changing these the structure of the feature branch. We're basically taking all these commits that happened and moving them on top of the master branch. So this tree actually changes. It takes this feature branch and moves it on top of the master branch. All these commits are going to get blown away the next time we force push, and they'll actually create new commits that are actually authored at a different time on top of this master branch. So this master branch then becomes something that looks a little more like this. Now you can probably see the benefits of this. Instead of having this where it's kind of like a stack, it looks a little unwieldy. And what makes it even more unwieldy is if you have like different branches all going on at the same time, then this becomes really, really, really confusing to look at. So we have something like this. And this, for the case of rebasing, would actually just be like a straight line all the way up the top. So it's a lot easier to look at. You can actually see that like the first feature branch is right here, the second feature branch is right here. And it makes it easier to do different things like bisecting and following the actual tree. You can look at the logs and everything is in a straight line. It's not like littered with these merge commits that actually serve no actual purpose when you're actually trying to look at the logs. But there are drawbacks to using rebases. The first is that you're actually rewriting these commits. You're taking them in their original authored state and actually moving them. So that this commit that this person authored is gone. It becomes a brand new commit that has the same changes, but is authored by is committed by a different person. So there's also pitfalls in that if you're not careful, then when you actually rebase, say somebody else committed something right here. If your master is somewhere else and you're not careful, you don't pull those changes in, this can be lost. So you have to be really careful when you're actually using it, because there's definitely pitfalls of using it in an unsafe manner. So that's rebasing versus merging.